Hello, noobs! I'm the boy who lived. No, no, not Harry Potter. He's off scouring the globe for Horcruxes and new ways of humiliating Ron. But I am a boy, and I assure you, I did live through childhood. Tonight, join me for a little kitchen magic as we turn some basic ingredients into delicious rock cakes. Note, if you're not a fan of the Harry Potter series, you might not get all the jokes, but you will get a delicious tea time treat. In the Harry Potter novels, rock cakes are often served by Hagrid the groundskeeper, who is the magical equivalent of a crazy cat lady. His rock cakes are often as hard as rocks themselves, but tonight's rock cakes will be as flaky as my English accent. First, preheat the oven to around 450 degrees Fahrenheit, which is just as hot as Emma Watson, but much more legal. Now, take 7 ounces flour and place it in a mixing bowl. Then get some sugar, just like Harry did with Ron's sister. Specifically, around 2 ounces of sugar, and add it to the bowl. Add 1 teaspoon baking soda, or as Harry Potter would say, bicarbonate of soda. Then again, Harry Potter would be much more likely to say, bicarbonate of Professor Snape doesn't like me, so he must be a villain. Then take 1/4 cup margarine or butter. If it isn't soft enough, melt it in the microwave for a few seconds. Pour it over the bowl and mix with the dry ingredients. Pour, like the Weasleys. Then add about 4 ounces of raisins. You can use any fruit you'd like, such as cranberries or strawberries, as long as they're dried and shriveled, like Joan Rivers. For an extra rocky rock cake, toss in a few ounces of chopped nuts. Now, you're going to add a dab of milk to the mixture, creating a firm dough. Only use as little milk as necessary, otherwise your dough will become too soft and unworkable, like modern-day Bruce Willis. Now you're going to sort the dough into 8 balls and place on a baking sheet, much like the sorting hat sorts the children of Hogwarts into their respective houses. Only unlike the houses of Hogwarts, each ball of dough shall be equal. Seriously, what has Hufflepuff ever done? At least, Ravenclaw had hot ethnic chicks. Bake for about 7 minutes, though cooking time may vary. Take them out when they're golden brown. These rock cakes are naturally dry and crumbly, and go wonderfully with a spot of tea or coffee. In fact, here's a tip for some exotic wizard tea you can grow at home. If there's one thing we learned at Hogwarts, it's that anything can be accomplished with the right herb. Well, except for bringing back Lily and James Potter. Catnip is easily grown in any apartment or garden. While catnip is like speed for cats, it has a slightly calming effect on humans and helps cleanse the body of toxins. Place 2 teaspoons of washed cut catnip in a cup and fill with boiling water. Let steep for at least 3 minutes and remove the leaves. This mild potion can be served as is or with a bit of milk, sugar, or honey. Expecto Snackus! Pip, pip, a tasty tea time treat that's so good, you'll snitch all over your bludgers. And if you followed my instructions, you don't have to be an 11-year-old British brat with arcane powers to whip up these magical munchies.